Penn State researchers recently discovered a way to revolutionize a widely used manufacturing process known as sintering. Sintering is the process of compacting and forming a solid mass by heat or pressure. This is traditionally done at temperatures of more than 1,000 degrees Celsius for many hours.
In the sintering process, you basically, for a given material, you'll take powder that can react to a temperature, and that temperature has to be below the melting temperature. And so this process is different from a melt forging process. It's a densification that is driven by molecules and atoms moving at the surfaces of these interfaces and minimizing that total amount of surface energy. Even the process, one could argue, of making a snowball is the compaction of particles and then applying some pressure with them. Maybe there's a local melting in the process of that, and then it helps bring things together.
People have been sintering ceramics, metals, plastics, and other materials for thousands of years. Today, sintering is used to create a wide variety of materials.
Refractory materials, they're used for brick technologies, tiles, alumina and zirconia, bearing type materials and pipes, very small functional materials for capacitor technologies. So for example, in your iPhone, you may have 700 pieces of ceramic all around capacitors. 3 trillion of them are made per year.
Randall and his team have developed a new technique where dense ceramics can be achieved with temperatures below 200 degrees Celsius and in minutes instead of hours. This new technique uses liquid, such as water, as a transient solvent to help densify the material.
What we're doing is using a liquid in a dissolution process, as it's called. It then works by an evaporation process. You're evaporating the liquid at the same time as you're dissolving it. And so you're catching this so-called dissolution and precipitation process, the crystal growth process, at the same time in and around surfaces of this powder compact. And in doing that, you pick up what is commonly known as the liquid phase sintering process. Now, that's been done before, but usually with phases that aren't transient. And so what's really important about this process is that this liquid is there and then it's gone. But in the process of it being there and gone, it's capturing all the exchange and diffusional and growth processes that you need to drive the sintering.
This approach was named the cold sintering process because of the drastically lower temperatures needed compared to conventional high temperature sintering. This breakthrough opens up a new age of ceramics processing.
The ability to be able to make things at the same quality that you can with a conventional process, but thousands of degrees below the temperatures that you could previously do by a sintering process. The ability to incorporate new materials into that whole process and make new types of functionality. And then finally, to have a system where it's basically densified in 20 minutes means that your throughput and your manufacturing yields could go up enormously. And so this is great for manufacturing, it is great for energy savings, it is great for the environment, it is great for new intellectual endeavors.
After making their initial discovery, the team has already successfully cold-sintered many materials.
Probably within 3 months, we had worked on over 50 systems and got them all to work. Dielectric materials that have very, very good properties. We're beginning to get more functional materials to work for piezoelectrics and for sensors and other things like this. The real breakthrough in terms of helping the planet will be in the infrastructural use of ceramics. So this is the glass, this is bricks, this is tiles. This is this type of space.
Through an industry university cooperative research partnership with North Carolina State University, Randall and his collaborators are exploring ways to implement cold sintering in everyday manufacturing.
The next step is to figure out how to then scale it into industry. So they, at the end of the day, have the machinery and the industrial know-how of how to scale this up.
Cold sintering has the potential to create cost-effective and energy-efficient ways of manufacturing materials used in everyday life while opening doors for a whole new realm of materials.
The most important thing about cold sintering is it will bring new ideas into a field, and this is right at the beginning, so there's plenty of room to expand those ideas.